When you think of x-rays, you might think about your last traumatic visit to the dentist or the first time you broke a bone. But x-rays are not just produced in doctor's offices. They also exist in space. X-rays come from some of the largest, hottest, and most energetic objects in the universe. They are emitted from million-degree gas spiraling into black holes, the explosive death of massive stars, and from gas between galaxies that live in clusters. These objects hold keys to questions that astronomers have spent long nights and countless computer hours trying to solve, like, how do black holes grow and shape their home galaxies? Where does dark matter like to live, and why there? Hitomi was an X-ray satellite that was recently launched to answer these questions. A detector on board, built by my group at NASA, would transform light from these faraway objects into patterns of lines. Each spectral line is a unique signature of a certain element, like oxygen, and allows us to learn about the environment in which it lives, maybe spewing out from near the center of a black hole. In contrast to the high precision of Hitomi, detectors on older satellites would give spectra of fat, bumps, and wiggles, blending together and confusing this crucial information. About a month after Hitomi's launch, a software glitch made the satellite spin itself into oblivion, flinging solar panels and scientific instruments into space. Luckily, Hitomi performed one observation of a cluster of galaxies called Perseus before it was lost, but something was off. Thanks to the improved detector technology, we could see better, and we realized how much we didn't know. The models we were using to understand the Perseus spectrum could not explain many of the features we saw. Some of the lines in these models were misplaced or even missing, meaning our calculations of temperatures, densities, and concentrations of elements present could be wrong. The problem? We don't understand enough of the basic atomic physics behind the creation of these spectral features. I'm working on this problem so that we get our science right. I do something called laboratory astrophysics. I perform and analyze data from experiments done in labs on Earth that reproduce conditions that exist in space. I use a giraffe-sized instrument called an electron beam ion trap, or an EBIT, to shoot electrons through gas to create ions. I determine how processes affecting those ions on quantum scales express themselves through the X-ray light they emit. I use a Hitomi-style detector to precisely measure the spectra of environments like the Perseus cluster, and I collaborate with theorists to use my data to verify current spectral models and soon create more accurate ones. There is hope that we will launch a successor to Hitomi, which will observe black holes and stellar explosions with unprecedented resolution. My laboratory predictions will enable us to better interpret these observations, and this time, get our science right.